Susan Chan here, Feng Shui Realtor based in New York City. Now, when people meet me, the first thing that they usually want to know is, what is Feng Shui? Now, Feng Shui is an ancient Chinese art that's over 4,000 years old. Feng means wind and Shui means water. And the goal of Feng Shui is to bring the harmony of nature into your home so that you feel nurtured and supported. Do you know that feeling when you walk into a space and it feels really good? That's Feng Shui. So how do I use feng shui in real estate? Now let me be upfront with you. There is no perfect feng shui home unless you find that plot of land and start from scratch. Now most people don't have the opportunity to do that, so we start where we can. Now, are you looking to buy? Great, we'll work together, hone in on your personal and professional goals, and we'll find that perfect space that you'll connect with, that you'll love, and that will be specific just for you. Don't you love that? Now, did you know that if you have a vision of your space and what you want, which is really important and why we work on that before we even go and look at properties, that you'll get more of what you want faster and easier? You've heard of vision boards, right? They're very powerful, and it's connected to feng shui because intention is everything. Now, remember me saying that because you'll hear me say that again and again. Feng shui is all about intention. Now, are you thinking of selling? We use feng shui to stage your home using feng shui techniques to create that feeling of ease and nurturing that's going to attract motivated buyers. And who wouldn't want that? Now, did you know that staging increases the values of offers by up to 10%? That's a lot, right? Now, in future Feng Shui Fridays, we'll dig deeper into the specifics that will positively enhance your feng shui experience using real estate. But right now, I want you to do this exercise with me. I want you to look around your space, and I want you to look at the things that make you feel really great and the other things that don't. What would you change? And then I want you to join me next Friday with this information because it'll be useful in the feng shui real estate process. Tune in next week. Now, did you like this video? Please subscribe or leave a comment or question, and I'll see you next Friday.